I believe key part of artificial general intelligence is understanding of the nature of things meaning. It's one of the main capabilities of natural man-human intelligence. It is logical to assume that the answer lies at the intersection of mathematical and neurophysiology. We proposed a fundamentally different understanding of biological neurons. We have shown that one neuron is capable of performing tremendous computational work. The main computational unit of the neuron is a cluster of receptors on the surface of neuron. There are hundreds of such clusters per synapse, and one cortical neuron have an average of 10,000 synapses. Clusters are also mechanisms for memory formation. Neurons do not work in isolation, but form a structure of about 100 of neurons called of mini column. The fact the cortical mini column is the main computational model of the brain was proposed by Vernon Mountcastle. In our model, each mini column corresponds to some context. That is their point of view. The input information of the cortex zone available to all mini columns on it. Each mini column has a set of rules for input information interpretation that are relevant only to its context. The result is a million possible interpretations. The input is viewed under a million different angles. But which interpretation is correct? One that has meaning, but what does it mean? All mini columns contain the same memory. It was possible to show that the memory capacity of one biological mini column is more than 500 megabytes of semantic data. The same memory is duplicated a million times in one zone of the cortex. And memory preservation is a side effect of it. The memory itself a computer. Active memory helps to understand how much the interpretation is similar to something previously seen. And when interpretation matches with the memory, then we can say that input information makes sense in this context. It's like convolution networks, turn inside out. Instead of convolution kernel applying to the different areas on the image. Here we recalculate the main image by moving it in each context, where the context are all possible combinations on distance and directions, so that later it can be computed, compared with memory. Muhammad goes to the mountain or Montes goes to Muhammad. It is important that the nature of context is the nature of a sense of things. Context are forming under the influence of incoming information. The main stage of training is the formatting of context space. Any phenomena, any futures, this is context. On the first step, there is being the something simple and well observable. Then accumulation of experience of how the world is changing in the presence of this observable. Gradually, it turns out that visible future no longer determines the phenomenon. Its hidden essence is revealed. At beginning, the table is four legs and tabletop, but later any surface on which it conventioned to manipulate something. The classic approach to recognition. Let's find that characteristic futures of the phenomenon. Let's find all of the sets of futures that phenomenon may have. The result is combinatorial explosion and requirement in huge data sets. The definition of a phenomenon so his meaning is completely different. If the interpretation is known in the context, then there is a phenomenon that corresponds to context. We get it. You can recognize a cat by tattered sofa. Contexts have a special organization, similar nearby. This is exactly the picture that we are observing when studying brain activity. This model is generalized in comparison with existing theories. Depending on which side you are looking at it, it results in convolution networks, capsule networks, Minsky frames, Chomsky formal grammatics, analysis of formal conceptions, and reinforcement learning. And of course, Jeff Konskin's model, but only in sense that we also have mini columns. Our model assumes that the brain operates semantic information. This leads to the rejection of gradients doesn't methods and the transition of methods based on combinatorial space. When tens of thousands of hypotheses are generated on the basis of even single information, which are tested on the following examples, that very quickly leads to the eliminate the false hypothesis. It was possible to show very good performance there, breaking complex codecs by this method. By the way, all this is biologically reliable. The semantic approach allows us to explain the nature of behavior and soul formation in reinforcement learning theory. There is concept of adaptive V-critics, classical Q-learning, in basic on attempt to assume the quality of the result of particular action in fixed situations. This leads all to the same approach, to sort out everything, combining cases according to the degree of their certain visible similarity. V-critics contain a model of the model of the world, and it is able to predict what the world will look like after the certain action. It can value this world based on their experience. It is important that this valuation is not given to an action, but to final result. To understand what action to choose, to solve all possible action to see at which one the value of the world will be highest. This is exactly what the cortex does in our model. For example, each action of the motion cortex zone, has its own context. Each context can calculate how current world will change after action is performed. The result is evaluated based on memory. The action that leads to the better world is chosen. Similarly, the formation of soul occurs. From birth, we do not have the algorithms of soul formation. We choose a soul that leads to the most profitable information picture. But at the same time, the brain subconsciously calculates a million parallel souls, valuing the quality of the situation, both of action and for soul, is based on emotions. Emotions seem self as a soul be estimates are not the born with us but formed during life. Interesting for realizing of research behavior, not the choice of maximum experience, but the probabilities choice, where the probabilities of choice is proportional to estimation of experience quality. At this moment, the connection of the semantic approach used to the brain with the laws of the quantum mechanism being to emerge. There is a lot of interesting parallels, but this is a top of another report. Thank you for your attention.